everyone, David J. Coon with Qigong Awareness. I wanted to invite you to practice with me today this old medical Qigong set, ancient set called the Eight Brocades. So first go ahead and place your feet a little wider than shoulder width apart. Make sure you hold the floor, kind of grip it with your feet. Start to sink your weight. It's called grounding. From here, hands come up and we're going to exhale. Let our breath and let our mind go into the ground. Just a little warm up here. Inhale. Slow through the nose. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. First exercise we're going to do in this particular set from this position. We're going to turn the hands over. We're going to inhale as we come up. We get to about the chest. We're going to interlace the fingers. We're going to reach forward. We're going to stretch, look up, and release. Exhale your breath here, inhale. Interlace the fingers, hold the breath in the lower belly if you can. And you're going to hold the breath and stretch, 2, 3, 4, exhale the breath. And if it's a little too tricky to hold the breath right now, don't worry about it, let it out whenever you can. Two, so inhale, here, hold, 2, 3, 4, exhale. Qigong practice, it is said that qi rides on the breath. So we are holding the breath. In this area of what is called lower dantian, the lower belly, exhale. When we're living in stress and we're living in a fight or flight, we tend to be mouth breathers. We breathe in through our mouth as opposed to breathing in through our nose. And we also tend to breathe into our lungs and not our lower belly. So most people have lost that connection to their lower belly. And the lower dantian can be thought of as a battery or a source of power. And over time, it loses its charge. Unless, of course, you're practicing Qigong, then over time, you might increase its charge. Exhale. Let's do one more. So we want to bring breath there. We want to bring attention there. We hold up the sky. And here we release the breath. Exhale. We're going to come back to this movement we did in the beginning, just as a clearing. Exhale. It is said that we have an energetic pole, a Tai Chi pole. It's like a staff, a column of light. Big tube that we live in at our center. It connects all the way up to the heavens and all the way down into the earth. Next exercise, we're going to bring our hands up. Some of you may have seen this exercise called hugging the tree. So you bring your hands up where you're hugging the tree. Sometimes it's also referred to as standing like a post. From this position, with your right hand, grip as though you're holding an archer's bow and arrow. And from here, you're going to pull as you extend the hand. From this position, the hands will come sweeping up like so. And from here, I pull with this hand, and I express, and I push away. I'm looking, I'm focusing this direction, this one. This particular exercise, very good for clearing the liver and also helping to open up your vision, increase the function of the eyes. Exhale here. Here, begin to inhale. From here, exhale. As you sink your weight, whatever's comfortable. Till your breath finishes. Do one more. Anytime we practice an exercise that has a martial quality to it, that's a very good exercise for both liver clearing, clearing liver qi stagnation, stress, anger, and helps us to focus and gain greater clarity. We're now going to go into exercise number 3, separate heaven and earth. From this position, sink. Bend the knees a little bit, bring the hands in. We're going to turn the right hand up and the left hand press down, separating heaven on top, earth on the bottom. Hands come in, circle inward. Left hand comes up, right hand presses down and a little bit back. Hands come up to meet, come in toward the center line. In this position, right hand goes up, left hand goes down, separating heaven. Earth, hands coming in, left hand going up, sinking the weight a little bit from this position here, letting the hands float and express, a little exhale there, perhaps a little inhale here, you can time it, exhale there. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. The next exercise that we're going to do is called Wise Old Owl Turns Its Head to Eliminate Fatigue. From this position, go out to a little bit of a horse stance where it's like you're sitting down on a horse. From this position, your hands are out at the side. We're going to turn them so that the palms are facing back in general and somewhat specific. This is called a standing bhuji posture. From this position here, we're going to inhale through the nose. As I do, I'm going to look to my right and then turn my palms to face you. And then as I exhale, turn to face the back. Now I'm going to look the other direction. Exhale back to front. Inhale. Exhale. Good for opening up the neck and shoulders. cripple turning. Feet in a little closer. Inhale here. Exhale here. Oh my. Energy breath goes down, roots itself into the ground, sinking. The next exercise, this Eight Brocades set, is called Sway the Head, Shake the Tail to Eliminate Heart Fire. This is number 5. From this position, go ahead and place your hands on your knees, whatever's comfortable here in terms of how deep you can go and so on, to be careful. So the first thing we want to do is I'm going to go to my right side. I'm going to go down toward my knee. I don't want to go past it. Off to my right. I want to circle now and come over to my left, and then from here I'm going to come back to center. I'm going to go back down toward my left knee. I'm going to go down whatever's comfortable here, come up, and circle back. Left, come up, back to center. Now the breath with this one takes a little practice. As I go toward the right, I'm going to exhale. I'm exhaling here. Right when I get to here, I inhale. I'm back to center. Hold my breath. Exhale. Here, inhale. Here, inhale. Dragon's breath here. I often feel like I'm setting things on fire when I do that. Releasing the fire. The shin, calms the mind, calms the spirit. From that position, come back to center, and here, exhale, inhale, exhale. So a little clearing in between. Before we go on to the sixth exercise, exercise number 6, is called holding the feet to clear kidneys, hips. I'm going to move in this fashion here and sink down, hands move here. Hands we'll come back. We're going to hold the low back kidney area here. So you can see that. We're going to inhale here. Inhale. Take in that breath. Exhale. Going to come around the insides of the feet, up the insides of the leg where the kidney meridian runs. Just adjacent to the navel center, hands come off the body, going up kidney meridians. And I walk my feet out and I sink. Exhale. Hands come back. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Sink. Exhale. Come back, inhale. Exhale. Just go down as far as whatever is comfortable. Inhale all the way up. Exhale. Excellent exercise for the kidneys. Kidneys are associated with longevity and vitality. Inhale. Exhale. Kidneys are also associated with a very concentrated qi called jing, which means essence. Kidneys are also associated with fertility. So those of you who are perhaps trying to get pregnant, be an excellent exercise for you. You can sink as deep or as little as you'd like there, but sink a little bit. Inhale here, holding to the kidneys. Exhale. Inhale. Tracing those kidney meridians a little bit on the inner legs, inner thighs. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Those kidney meridians run just adjacent to the outside of the navel center. They come up the center line. Hands come off. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more. Inhale. Exhale. Exhale. Inhale here. Exhale here. Inhale here. Exhale here. This next exercise, number 7 of the 8 brocades, is called clench the fists and glare fiercely. So from this position here, go ahead and take your fingers and start to coil them up. Take the thumb, wrap it over the first two fingers. Do the same with the other hand. Curl the fingers, wrap the thumb over the other two fingers. Take that hand, for me this is going to be my right hand, I'm going to turn it over. And I'm going to pull it down here toward my hip. In this position, I'm going to stick my other hand out in front of me. So you see this in many martial arts where they punch like so. This is a Qigong exercise that has a martial quality to it. So once you find that position, from here I'm going to stand somewhat tall, knees not too bent, just a little bit bent. From this position, I'm going to inhale through my nose, and I'm going to exhale as I start to sink. I'm going to trade positions of hands. When I come up, I'm going to inhale, exhale. And I'm going to glare fiercely. From the gut. Be easy, especially when you're first beginning this. You don't want to strain anything. Very little tension in the arms in this one. Unless you want to make it martial art. But if the emphasis is just on the chi clearing, then the arms stay very relaxed for the most part. Seven. Click the heels seven times. We could do it more, but in the ancient set, it was done seven times. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Thank you very much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed this practice.